Today is May 8th, 2020. Unquote. Little did he know. Clarence E. Bud Anderson is a retired United States Air Force colonel and World War II fighter pilot. At age 98, he is our country's ranking living fighter ace with 16 and a quarter air victories flying the P-51 Mustang over Germany and Europe. After the war, he spent most of his 30-year Air Force career as a test pilot. His last assignment was as wing commander of a tactical fighter wing in Vietnam. He is highly decorated and an inductee of the National Aviation Hall of Fame.
And probably had two spares behind that. And then the leader would set course. We'd fly kind of line of rest on a straight course towards our rendezvous with the bombers. And then we'd pull up at the rendezvous point and then remember the B-17s, B-24s on their tail. They had these big emblems, a square D or a triangle J. Big letters up on the vertical stabilizers. Then we would set up a zigzag course across the top of them to keep our speed up. We were generally flying, well above 25,000 feet. The bombers were between 20 and 25. And we'd sometimes you'd be up at 30, 36, 37. Trying to get on top of the overcast, and it's minus 50 up there. I could make it. And depending on what time after January of 44, we pretty much had free range. Doolittle had turned us loose, so let us follow the enemy down to the ground.
Through a period of some kind of sacrifice for a better good. And I think it's something that we can all relate to.
Where did the idea come from for your dad to do these programs on location, often at frontline military bases?
Actually, it all happened sort of by chance. One of Dad's writers had a brother who was serving at March Airfield. He said, you know, he told his brother that they were star for entertainment, and why didn't he bring the Bob Hope show down there? And he did, and the rest is history.
Because great aviator Jimmy Doolittle said that Bob Hoover was the best stick and rudder pilot ever. Hoover was a World War II fighter pilot flying from North Africa over the Mediterranean and Sicily. He was shot down by the Luftwaffe and spent 16 months in Stalag I, a German prison camp in northern Germany. After several attempts to escape, He was finally successful. He commandeered a German fighter plane and flew himself to safety in Holland. Later, as a test pilot, he flew Chase on the Bell XS-1 rocket flight that broke the sound barrier for the first time in 1947 and did take that famous photo of the flight. He is an inductee of the National Aviation Hall of Fame. Adlai Stevenson once said, "Patriotism is not a short and frenzied outburst of emotion, but the tranquil and steady dedication of a lifetime." Well, measured by that yardstick, there is no greater patriot than Bob Hoover, for love of country has indeed been his steady dedication of a lifetime.
At the same base.
Charles, your incredible career in the Air Force, what is your experience?
But it lifted up the challenge of being prepared and this is a challenge to our young people today. There's so much going on. But it's the things they need to know to be a part of our country's future and continue to enjoy the freedoms that we have.
Arsenal of Democracy events scheduled for May 7 and May 8 have been postponed until late September. The evening of September 24th, 8 World War II heroes will share their wartime experiences with the audience at a gala dinner. The following morning, more than 100 World War II type aircraft will do a giant flyover of the Lincoln Memorial, the Washington Monument, down the mall over the World War II Memorial, the new Eisenhower Memorial, Smithsonian Air and Space, and the Capitol. The events will commemorate and honor those who died in World War II and all who served then and now in the military and the civilians who work at home to help protect our freedoms. For the Arsenal of Democracy, I'm David Hartman.